Good day to all of you students. In this video, we are going to teach you what type of functions are there. And because this is just the beginning of class 11th, I will only give you very elementary information about different types of functions, the properties the functions can possess, so that you are able to understand future chapters also. So in this video, I will not give you much detailed knowledge. That will come to you as you grow in your syllabus. As and when we teach you at the appropriate time the detailed knowledge of the properties of functions that I am telling you. So in this video, I am only giving you elementary information, so that when I teach you the next chapter of trigonometry, you are able to understand the properties of trigonometric functions. So generally, you already know what are functions that has been taken up. You have to understand there is something called many one function, and there is one function. So what is a many one function and what is a one function? See children, if you have a arrow diagram or Venn diagram like this, from A to B, f is a function from A to B. Here there are elements A, B, C, and here there are elements P, Q, supposing. So A corresponds to P, B corresponds to Q, and C also corresponds to Q, and there is supposing R over here. And we may have this type of thing. From A to B, there is a function F, A, B, C, and B, Q, A corresponding to P, B to Q, and C to Q. Now children, if you observe nicely, these both are functions because every element of this domain is associated with unique element of codomain that you can make out. Children, here two elements are corresponding to same element. So many elements are corresponding to same element, therefore this becomes many one. And here also it is many one because more than one element are corresponding to the same element. So if you see a situation like this, if you find any two elements of the domain corresponding to same element of the domain, codomain, then it is called a many one function. This is a case of many one function. Like if I have a function from, f is a function from say z to z, and fx equal to x square, supposing this type of function I am having. So this will be z to z. Z, you know, is a set of integers, that is the function f. Minus 1 will correspond to 1, and 1 also will correspond to 1 because square. F of minus 1, minus 1 square. F of 1, 1 square. Both will correspond to same element. Like that, there may be other also may be corresponding to same, but the fact is, we are able to locate two elements of domain which are corresponding to same element of codomain. What others are doing, now I am not concerned. If I have to show that my function is many one, I should look for two elements in the domain which are corresponding to same element of the codomain. If I am able to do that, then it is a many one function, otherwise it is a one function. So this is a many one function, and if I talk about one function, then it may be like this. So supposing set A and set B, here there is A, B, C, P, Q, R. So A corresponds to P, B to Q, and C to R. One corresponding to one only. And here, like this, A to B, F is a function, A, B, C, P, Q, R, and S. So A corresponds to P, B to Q, and C to R. This also is one, because every element of domain is corresponding to unique element of codomain. No two elements of domain are corresponding to same element of the codomain. Can you see? No. Therefore, it's a one function, this one and this one. So right over here for you, this is many one, this is many one, this is also many one, this is one, and this is one, like this. So one, what will happen? You will not be able to find two elements of domain which will be corresponding to same element of codomain. That won't be able to, you won't be able to do it. So it will become one function. So children, if you have to prove the function to be many one, either look for two elements. You think of two elements in the domain which can correspond to the same element of codomain. Like I thought over here, fx is x square, so I immediately thought 1 and minus 1 will correspond to the same element. So that is method of proving the function to be many one. You try to think of two elements which may correspond to the same element. Another method is theoretical method. That supposing, now please try to understand, this is set A, this is set B. This element A, it corresponds to P, and P is the value of function for A, so P will be called FA. B corresponds to Q, so Q is the value of function for B. When I put B in F, I get Q, so I write Q as FB. So FA and FB will be coming in the codomain. They are values of the function for the x equal to A and x equal to B. I have already told you before also. FA and FB are the values of function for the value of variables as A and B. When the value of variable is A, the value of function is FA, which I am calling as P. When the value of variable is B, the value of function is FB, which I am calling as Q, like this thing. So if I want to prove a function to be 1-1, what I will have to do? I will take two elements from the codomain. I will write let FA equal to FB. And by taking FA equal to FB, I will prove A equal to B. If I am able to do it, see, I am not saying I will always able to prove it. If I am able to prove A equal to B, then it is a 1-1 function, otherwise it is a many one function. This will imply F is 1-1. This is the method to prove a function to be 1-1. Like for example, F is a function from R to R and Fx, supposing it is 2x plus 3. So here there are some elements, some real numbers. Here also some real numbers are there. Okay, I write like this. This is the function A. So A and B. Fx is 2x plus 3. So what will be Fa? Instead of x, I put A. This will become 2a plus 3. So here I will get value 2a plus 3. What will be F of B? I'll put B in F. So FB will be 2b plus 3. So this will be 2b plus 3. I hope you can understand. So F of A, that will be 2a plus 3. Matlab A will correspond to 2a plus 3 and B will correspond to 2b plus 3. Now what did I do? This is actually FA for me and this is FB for me. If I want to prove that it is 1-1 function, what do I do? Supposing FA equal to FB, I take like this. Supposition. We will begin like this. Suppose FA is FB. What is the meaning of FA? 2A plus 3. And what is the meaning of FB? 2B plus 3. 3 cancel out. So 2A equal to 2B. That means A equal to B. So children, over here FA equal to FB has implied A equal to B. Therefore, this will be a case of 1-1 function. And supposedly, I have got like this, a function from R to R, F, and Fx is given by the formula x square. So A will correspond to A square because x becomes x square, and B will correspond to B square. This will be FA and this will be FB. When I take x as A, FA becomes A square. When I take x as B, when the value of variable is B, I put B in F, I get FB and that is B square as per the formula. FA will be A square, FB will be B square. So now what do I do? Let FA equal to FB. So this implies A square equal to B square. That implies A equal to plus minus B. That does not prove A equal to B. A square equal to B square means A can be plus minus B. So I don't get the implication. I don't get the implication that A is B. I get two implications. A can be B also, A can be minus B also. So I don't get a fixed implication that A equal to B. So because FA equal to FB has not implied A equal to B. Alone A equal to B is not being implied. Something else also is being implied. Therefore, this is the case of many one function. Therefore, it is a many one function. And here, therefore, it is 1-1 function. This is another example. So, this is what is about 1-1 and many one function. Children, please copy. I want to teach you some more things also. Please pause and copy. I am waiting for you. Okay. So, now children, from graph, how to make out whether your function is 1-1 or many one? This is very important. This thing is very important. So, because in JE and all that, you should have very good grip on the graphs. So understand that a 1-1 function will have a graph like this. Here x-axis, here I will plot the values of variable. This is y-axis, here I plot the values of fx. If my function is a Merriman function, children, then your graph may go like this. And if you draw any one horizontal line, it will cut the graph only at one point. Means, if you are in a position to draw a horizontal line, which may cut the graph in more than one point, then graph will become many one. And just like this, I'm telling you, supposing we have a graph like this, x-axis here x, y-axis here fx. Supposing I am having a graph like this, so I know if I draw this horizontal line, it will cut the graph in so many points. This is one point, this is one point, this is one point. If I am able to draw at least one horizontal line, which may cut the graph at more than one point, 2 points is also sufficient for us, then this is the graph of many one. And if you draw any horizontal line over here, children, it will cut the graph only at one point. So this is the case of 1-1 function. So if you want to test whether your function is many one or 1-1, draw its graph and see that whether are you able to draw a horizontal line which can cut the graph at more than one point. If you are in a position to do that, then your graph becomes many one. But if you find that no, you cannot draw any horizontal line which may cut the graph in more than one point, like this case, then it is a case of 1-1 function. So how to identify from the graph whether your function is 1-1 or many one, that I told you. Okay, then see. I will teach you something about how many functions are there. So children, please understand. Supposing there is a set A with me and set B. Supposing A and B is there and 1 and 2 is there. Okay, F is a function from A to B. Children, how many functions we can have? One thing is very sure, that A and B both should correspond to at least one element over here. The first option with me is that A may correspond to 1, B may correspond to 1. Chalo ek aur C le lete hain, C may correspond to 1. This is one option, this is one function. Still it is a function. Or it may happen that A and B, F is a function, A, B, C, 1 and 2, all may correspond to 2. That is okay. Right? Okay, then another option may be like this, A to B, A, B, C. See, A and B may correspond to 1 and C may correspond to 2. And in the next option, A and B, this is function F, A, B, C. In the next option, A and B may correspond to 2 and C may correspond to 1. That is another option. Still it is a function. Then we may have like this, from A to B, A, B, C, 1 and 2. Earlier A and B were corresponding to 1. Now A and C may correspond to 1 and B may correspond to 2. That is okay. Another option may be A to B, A, B, C. Earlier A and C were corresponding to 1. Now they both may correspond to 2 and B may correspond to 1. That also is there. So A B taken, A C taken. Now we take B C, A and B, A B C 1 and 2. It may happen that B and C both may correspond to 1, A may correspond to 2. Or it may happen that now A and C were cross, B and C were corresponding to 1. So B and C may correspond to 2 and A may correspond to 1. There are no other options possible. See, first we took A, B, C all corresponding to 1. Then we took all A, B, C corresponding to 2. Then we made pairs of A and B. A, B, B, C and A, C. First A, B going to 1, C going to 2. Then A, B going to 2, C going to 1. that was AB and C. Then we took AB and we have taken, then we took BC, I think, or AC. A and C both going to 1, and then A and C both going to 2. Then even for BC, both B and C going to 1, both B and C going to 2. How many functions are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Totally 8 functions are there. Now children, if the number of elements becomes very large, you know it will become very difficult for you to count or make diagrams like this. So what is the formula? Formula goes like this. Supposing there are m elements in the domain and n elements in the codomain. So write over here. If the number of elements in domain is m and number of elements in the codomain is n, f is a function from a to b, then total functions that will be n raised to n. So you can see over here 2 raised to 3, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are getting it. This is the formula for total functions. Whether they are many one or one one. See, there are many one over here. Here also many one. And whether it is many one or one one, these many functions will be got. Here I think we cannot have one one function because here elements are more, here elements are less. So we cannot have a one one type of function. But even then, total number of functions, whether many one, one one, into, onto, whatever, that will be n raised to n. Please understand. If I want to have number of functions which are 1 1 only, number of 1 1 functions, number of 1 1 functions, the formula is number of, I say, OO, that will be equal to NPM only if n is greater than or equal to m, greater than or equal to 1. Of course, n and m are integers, they have to be greater than or equal to 1. And n should be more than n, that you already know, because whatever number is here, that will be less than n or equal to n. Therefore, n more than or equal to m, more than or equal to 1. At least one element should be there in the domain and codomain, otherwise the function will not at all exist. Therefore, we are saying n and m should be at least greater than or equal to 1. At least one element should be there in domain and codomain. And n should be more than m, otherwise npm cannot exist, because you know that what is the formula for npm? That is n factorial upon n minus m factorial. This also has been told to you. So these are the number of 1 1 functions. So now if I see here n was 2 and m was 3. So n was 2, m was 3, this condition was not satisfied. Therefore we cannot have any 1 1 function, that will be 0 1 1 functions, and you can see there are no 1 1 functions. So what is the formula for 1 1 functions? I have told you npm, where n should be more than or equal to m, should be more than or equal to 1, that is very obvious. And npm means how much? N factorial upon n minus m factorial. So once I know, children, what is the number of 1 1 functions, I know that number of 1 1, I write like this, number of 1 1 functions plus number of many 1 functions will be total functions, nt. So I write over here, this is nt, n total. So once I know what is 1 1, I know nt, I can get mo. So number of many one functions will be nt minus no. So if you are asked how many one functions are there, first find out nt by taking n raised to m. Then find out n 1 1 by taking the formula npm. And then subtract, you will get number of many one functions. So I taught you what is a many one function, many one function and all that, children. And also I told you the formula, how many total functions will be there, how many one functions will be there, how many one one functions will be there. I told you by graph how to decide whether a function will be many one or one one, and theoretically how to prove whether function is one one or many one, that also I told you. If you have this much basic idea, it will be very good, children. Okay, please pause and copy, then we go to next type of functions. Now the next property of functions that you should be knowing is whether a function is onto or into. So when do I say that my function is onto, and when do I say my function is into? We have to understand that. Now supposing, children, I have got a function from A to B. Supposing there is a function from A to B. Like, okay, first I will show you by Venn diagrams. Dekho. Supposing I have got a function like this. A to B, that is a function f. A, B, C and B, Q. A corresponds to B like this. Then I may have a thing like this. A, B, C, P, Q, R. A corresponds to B, B to Q and C to R. Then I may have a thing like this. F, a function from A to B. A, B, C, P, Q, R, S. It may go like this. Or it may go like this. So C going to R, B to Q and A to B. Children, in the first and second case I realize that domain is PQ and range is also PQ. Here domain is PQR and range is also PQR. So in F1 and F2, and let me call F3 and F4. So what do I see for F1 and F2? That domain, the codomain and the range both are same. So for F1 and F2, they have a particular property that range of the function RF is equal to codomain of the function. And for F3 and F4, I can see that domain is PQRS, but here range is only PQ. Here the codomain is PQRS, but the range is only PQR. So in both the cases, the codomain and range are different sets. So for F3 and F4, I observe that range of the function is not equal to codomain of the function. So whenever range is equal to codomain, this becomes onto function and this becomes into function. This is the definition. If RF and CF are equal, it is onto. If RF is not equal to CF, it is into function. Onto function is also called surjective function, children. It is subjective function. And I forgot to tell you over there, then you please turn your page and write that 1-1 function is called injective function. So 1-1 function is called injective, another name, and onto is called surjective, another name. We don't have another name for into or many one. We don't have. For 1-1 we are having a name injective. For onto we are having a name surjective. So now you understand what is an into function and what is an onto function. In into function, the range and codomain will mismatch, whereas for an onto function, the range and codomain will be equal sets. How to analyze from the graph whether a function is onto or into? So children, take an example that supposing f is a function from R to R and fx is x square supposing. So I know that whatever real numbers I will put over here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3 or half, root 2, minus root 2, minus root 3, whatever, they will become positive because x square is positive, or it may be 0. F0 will be 0. So what are the answers I will get for the values of function? Fx is x square. Value of function is x square. The value of the function cannot be negative because it is square of x. So value of the function will be only 0 or positive. It won't be negative. Therefore, when I draw the Venn diagram for R to R, R means all the real numbers. Here I will have negative numbers also, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 0, 1, 2, 3 and half, another symbol also will be there. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 0, 1, 2 and so on. I know minus 1 will correspond to 1, minus 2 will correspond to 4, minus 3 will correspond to 9, 0 will correspond to 0, 1 to 1, 2 to 4 and like this. My answers will never be negative because square cannot be negative. So whatever numbers I am picking up from here, from the domain, x will be from here, any number that I pick up, it will become square, the square will be always positive or 0. That means in the range, only 0 and positive numbers will come, these negative numbers will not come. Therefore, I can make out in this case, RF is not equal to CF, therefore it is an into function. And children, if you draw the graph of this function, fx equal to x square, taking these are values of x and these are values of y, I told you, values of domain are plotted on x-axis and values of range are plotted on y-axis, codomain also on y-axis. So this is your x-axis and y-axis. If you plot the graph, it will come out to be like this. This will be your graph if you take with the points and plot. So you can see that my graph, if I see my graph, if I throw light on this graph, perpendicular to y-axis, you have to imagine like this. If you throw light on y-axis, perpendicular to y-axis, then the shadow of this graph will fall only on this much region. Here there won't be any shadow. So whatever is the shadow covered on y-axis, that is your range. You draw the graph and then throw light from both the sides perpendicular to y-axis and see whatever is your graph, what will be the shadow, on how much portion of the y-axis the shadow will fall. I can make out that this graph will give me shadow only on this much region. Therefore, this is your range, 0 and positive numbers, exactly what we are thinking. The shadow will not fall over here. But your codomain is R. Codomain is full y-axis given to us. So codomain is full y-axis because codomain is R. R means all the real numbers. This is on x-axis, this is on y-axis. My codomain is entire y-axis and the range is only 0 to positive. Therefore, your function is into function. So from graph, how to make out? First draw the graph, then throw light from both the directions perpendicular to y-axis and try to see on how much portion of y-axis the shadow of the graph will fall. Whatever points are covered by the shadow, that is your range. Remaining is not the range. So if I have a graph like this, children, if I have a graph like this, this is height 1, this is height minus 1, this is x-axis, and this is supposing y-axis. And my graph is like this. Only in this much region always. So it always remains over here and over here, between 1 and minus 1. So if you throw light, you know only that this much portion of the y-axis will be covered because graph is only in this much region. So what will be your range from minus 1 to 1, that will be your range. Whereas codomain can be full R. So if your codomain is full R, full y-axis, then again this is the case of into function because your range is not matching. And supposedly, I am given fx equal to 2x plus 3, f is a function from R to R. Your codomain is R. Now, children, this is a straight line. Y equal to 2x plus 3, y equal to mx plus c, if you can recall now. You have done bridge course, elementary knowledge of lines you are learning. Fx is y actually, plotted on y-axis. So, y equal to 2x plus 3, this is the graph of a straight line, having slope 2 and y-intercept 3. How will the graph come? The graph will come like this. Now you have done lines, you know. Slope will be 2, tan theta will be 2, and your y-intercept 3, so this is the point 0, 3. Positive slope, but the acute angle the line will make, the line will go like this. Or you can take points and decide, and you can draw the graph. That's as you have been doing in class 9 and 10. Graph of a linear equation. Y equal to 2x plus 3, take some points. Y is equal to 2x plus 3, so take x and y some points. When x will be 0, y will be 3. When x will be 1, y will be 5. When minus 1, it will be 1. Take the points 0, 3, 1, 5, minus 1, 1, and stretch the line. So this line can go up to infinity upwards, it will keep going up and up and up. And bottom also, it will go keep going down and down. Therefore, if you throw light from this direction, or from this direction, perpendicular to y-axis, you know entire y-axis will be covered. The shadow will fall on the entire y-axis. No portion of y-axis will be left untouched by the shadow. So what is the range? Your range is R. And your codomain also is R only. Therefore, this is a onto function, surjective function. So from graph, how to make out whether it is onto or into? This is the way to do it. Please pause and copy, children. Please pause and copy. I want to teach you more things. So children, now graph is okay. How to make out from the graph whether a function is onto or into, that I told you. Now theoretical method is what? Like in case of 1-1 onto, there was theoretical method to prove 1-1 function. F A equal to FB should imply A equal to B. So similarly, to prove onto or into, so supposing it is like this. If you want to prove the function to be into function, children, if the function is into, that means some element from here will be left out, it will not be included in the range. Like the simplest example I am giving you, if f is a function from R to R and fx equal to x square, okay, so you know that because here there is square, negative numbers will not be included in the range, that you can make out very easily. So you know that numbers like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 won't be available over here to have these as answers. So now because you know that the range is 0 or positive, you know negative numbers will not fall in the range. So because you are able to think like this, so you say suppose there is some x belonging to A, and let this be the set of real numbers and set of real numbers. Let x belong to A such that f of x is equal to minus 1. So why you are taking x as minus 1? Because why you are taking minus 1? Because you know minus 1 will not be included in the range. By foresight, by intelligence, you have been able to make out very quickly that minus 1 will not fall in the range. So you say, okay, we accept that the function is onto function. If it is an onto function, then there must be some element over here for which we get the answer as minus 1. Because if we have no element over here for which answer is minus 1, then minus 1 will not be included in the range. Just like what I am saying, supposing you say there is 1 over here, for 1 there is element 1 over here. 1 will give you answer 1 because fx is x square, so square of 1 will be 1. If there is 4, then there is 2 over here. If there is 9, then there is 3 over here. If there is 2, then there is root 2 over here. If there is 3, then there is root 3 over here. That means if this is an onto function, then for every element over here, there should be some element over here, such that when I put this element in function, I get this is the answer. Again, I am repeating, for every element in the codomain, whether 9, 4, 1, 2, 3, whatever, for every element in the codomain, I should have some element in the domain, such that when I put that element in F, formula of F, I get that answer. Like, f1 will be 1, so for 1 I have got 1. F of 2 will be 4, that means for 4 I am having element 2 in the domain, such that f of 2 is 4. For element 9 in the codomain, I am having 3 in the domain, such that f of 3 is 9. So for every element in the domain, there should be some element over here, x, such that when I put x in f, I get answer as the required element. So therefore, I am saying, supposing there is x in A such that f of x is minus 1. Now, what is f of x? X square. X square equal to minus 1. But that is not possible because square of a number cannot be negative. But we know that x square is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, x square cannot be equal to minus 1. So whatever is our supposition, that is false. That means for minus 1, there is no element over here. That means minus 1 will not be included in the range. So at least one element is being left out, I am sure, from the entire set of real numbers. One element is left out. So range is not R, and therefore it is an into function. So theoretically, we have to prove like this. Therefore, minus 1 will not be included in the range of function. Therefore, RF will not be equal to R, the set of real numbers, because one element is going away from the set of real numbers. And therefore, RF is not equal to CF, which is equal to R, the set of real numbers. And therefore, F is into function. Like this, we think. And for onto function, what will happen? For every element, you will be able to get some element over there. This case will not happen if it is an onto function. So, into function, you will get some element over here, for which you won't get some element over here, such that f of x is equal to minus 1. But in case of onto function, that won't happen. Like onto function, if you think, say f of f is a function from z to z and fx equal to x plus 1. So let us see, children. Let us see what will be the range. See, I will have 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2 and 3. Fx becomes what? X plus 1. So whatever x I put in f, that will become 1 more than that. तो माइनस थ्री विल बिकम माइनस टू, माइनस टू विल बिकम माइनस वन, माइनस वन विल बिकम जीरो, जीरो विल बिकम वन, वन विल बिकम टू, टू विल बिकम थ्री एंड थ्री विल बिकम फोर एंड लाइक्स. सो आई कैन सी माई रेंज विल बी जीरो प्लस माइनस वन प्लस माइनस टू एंड अदर्स ऑल्सो आई विल गेट. तो सपोजिंग यू मे से सर व्हाट विल बी द नंबर ओवर हियर फॉर व्हिच आई मे गेट आंसर माइनस सेवन. तो यू राइट माइनस एट ओवर हियर, माइनस एट प्लस सेवन विल बी माइनस सेवन. इफ समबडी सेज हाउ टू गेट माइनस फिफ्टी तो आई विल राइट माइनस फोर्टी नाइन. तो माइनस फोर्टी नाइन प्लस वन, ओके माइनस फिफ्टी वन, सॉरी माइनस फिफ्टी वन प्लस वन विल बी माइनस फिफ्टी. इफ सपोजिंग से सपोजिंग समबडी सेज सर हाउ टू गेट हंड्रेड आंसर आई विल से पुट नाइनटी नाइन. If somebody says, sir, how to get answer 1000, then I put 999 over here. How to get answer 0, I will put minus 1. So what you are doing, children? If you, whatever answer you want, you are taking element over here, which is 1 less than this. That means for every x over here, whatever x, or let me call it y over here. X we take from here, and this we call y. Y is fx. For every y, what I will get? Y minus 1. Because for 100, 99, minus 50, minus 51, 1000, 99, so 1 less. So for every y, there will be y minus 1. Such that when I put y minus 1 in f, I will get answer as y. See, what is fx? Fx is what? X plus 1. So what will be f of y minus 1? I am putting y minus 1. Y minus 1 from here. Y minus 1 means wherever there is x, put y minus 1. Wherever there is x, put y minus 1. So y minus 1 plus 1. See, it is equal to y. So for every y, there will be y minus 1 in the domain, such that f of y minus 1 is equal to y. Therefore, this is the case of onto function. This becomes an onto function or surjective function. This way we think. I write nicely for you. Surjective. Okay, children. So, how to decide whether the function is into function or onto function theoretically, that I told you from graph also how to check that I told you. And now how many onto and into functions can be there? So please remember, f is a function from A to B. Number of elements in A are m, and number of elements in B are n. Supposing, so onto functions will be given by sigma ncr minus 1 raised to n minus r r raised to m, or let me write like this first, minus 1 raised to n minus r n c r r m, r goes from 1 to n. This is the formula for onto, a bit tough, but that is okay. I will try to solve few sums so that you understand how to apply this formula. The number of onto functions will be sigma minus 1 raised to n minus r n c r and r raised to m. Now what is r? R is given from 1 to n. So how to apply this formula? Please children, please pause and copy so that I can do some examples for you. Please pause and copy. See, the formula with me is for number of onto functions. Number of elements in A is m, and number of elements in B is n. So number of onto functions, that is sigma r is equal to 1 to n minus 1 raised to n minus r, and then it is n c r r raised to n. So this will be equal to, r will start from 1, then 2, then 3, will put 1 by 1. Supposing I have number of elements in A as 2 and number of elements in B as 3. So my m becomes 2 and n becomes 3. I put over here the number of onto functions. This will be sigma minus 1 raised to n minus r, 3 minus r. ncr means 3cr. N is 3, we know. 3cr. R we don't know. R will start from 1 to n. 1 by 1 we will take. And r raised to m. M means how much? 2. And r goes from 1 to n. N is what? 3. That means first r will be 1. Then it will be 2, then it will be 3. R goes from 1 to 3. So first I put R as 1, put over here minus 1, 3 minus 1, 3C1, 1 square plus put RS2, this becomes minus 1, 3 minus 2, 3C2, 2 square. Then put RS3, minus 1 raised to 3 minus 3, 3C3 and 3 square. So this will be minus 1 raised to 2, this will be 1. 3C1 will be 3, that you know, 1 square will be 1. Minus 1 raised to 1, that will be minus 1. 3C2, 3 factorial, 3 minus 2 factorial, 2 factorial. So 6 upon 2, that is 3. And that is 4. Minus 1 raised to 0 will be 1, 3C3 will be 1, and this will be 9, 3 square. So this becomes 3 minus 12 plus 9. So 15, this will be 9 plus 3, 12, 0. So there are 0 onto functions. So there are no onto functions for this case. Let us take up one more. If I can report this. Supposing I take number of elements in A as 4, number of elements in B as 2. So this is my M and this is my M. We know that number of onto functions, that is sigma r is equal to 1 to n minus 1 raised to n minus r n c r r raised to n. So this will be sigma r is equal to 1 to n means how much? 2 minus 1 raised to. What I do is I had taken 2 and 3. So now I take 4 and 2. Okay, let us see. First I am taking r as n is 2 with me. So 2 minus r, then 2 cr, and r raised to m means how much? 4. So now this is equal to, first we take r as 1. So this will become minus 1 raised to 2 minus 1, then 2 c 1 and 1 raised to 4 plus minus 1 raised to, put r as 2, 2 minus 2, 2 c 2 and 2 raised to 4. So minus 1 raised to 2 minus 1, this will be minus 1. 2c1 will be 2 and this will be 1. This will be 1, minus 1 raised to 0. 2c2 will be 1 and this will be 16. So this will be minus 2 plus 16, that will be 14. So 14 onto functions will be there, like this sort of thing. I hope I did not make mistake over here. N was 3, it was 2 over there, okay. So here 14 functions and here no functions. So once you know the number of onto functions, children, and you know that number of onto plus number of into, that will be number of total functions, and that is n raised to n. So what will be number of into functions? That will be n raised to m minus number of onto functions. So first find out total functions, that is n raised to n. Then find out onto functions. Two examples are given you. Subtract, you will get number of into functions. This way we can get the number of onto functions and into functions. So that was about onto and into, children. Please pause and copy. I'll do more, many more things.